With Nvidia's ChatRTX, you can have a chatbot running on your local machine, which can answer questions based on your own data. You simply select a folder on your machine containing documents, and you can start asking the chatbot questions about the contents of those files. This can be useful for a wide range of use cases. For instance, you could select a folder containing all your lecture notes, work documents, invoices, manuals, or whatever you'd like. Nvidia ChatRTX provides a few benefits over something like ChatGPT. First, it's completely free to use, and it uses open source models for the LLM. It is also secure since the model is running locally, and none of your data is being passed over the internet to some external company. To get started, go over to this webpage and then click on Download Now. I have to warn you that this download will take a while, as this file is about 30 gigabytes big. And if we scroll down to the system requirements, you will notice that you need about 35 gigs to host this application. And that is because this application uses open source models like Mistral or Llama 2, and those files tend to be quite big. But that is just the price to pay for running these applications locally. And for the GPU, you need an Nvidia 30 or 40 series RTX card as well. After downloading that file, extract its contents and then go into the folder and double click on Setup. Then click on Agree and Continue. Make sure that you have Mistral 7B checked and then click on Next to start the setup process. And after setup completes, this pop-up will be displayed and you can then access ChatRTX from this URL, like so. I do need to warn you that the setup process can take quite a while, and for me, it took about 30 minutes to complete. We can now start using ChatRTX. This interface is quite simple. From the AI model section, we can select from any of the models that we have installed on our system. And by default, I only have access to the Mistral 7B model, but it is possible to install additional models as well. Then under Dataset, we can specify the folder which contains our documents. And to test this out, I've created a folder containing one Word document. And this document simply contains the lecture notes of some astrophysics class. So I've selected folder path, and that's actually all we have to do to start chatting to these documents. So let's ask a question that's contained in this document. Let's ask how stars are born. So in the chat, let's say, how are stars born? And this response came back pretty much instantly. And we also get a reference to the document containing this answer. Let's also ask something related to the size and mass of a star. Like, what does the size and mass of a star determine? And I received this answer pretty much instantly, along with the reference. And if we compare this to our notes, this is pretty accurate. So we can add additional files to this folder. So let's simply create a new Word document. And by the way, this folder can contain different file types, like text files, PDF, and Word docs. So let's simply create a new Word document. Let's call it My Details. And in this file, I'll enter something like Leon is from South Africa. And let's save that file. But watch what happens when I ask a question about that file. Like, where is Leon from? And you will get a response saying it doesn't know this information. So whenever you change the files in that folder, it's very important to go back to Dataset and to click on this Refresh Dataset button. This will effectively load all the documents in that folder and upsert the contents of those files into a vector store. Now let's ask that question again, where is Leon from? And this time we get the correct response, along with the reference document. But what exactly is going on behind the scenes? And I actually found this to be extremely fascinating. On this page, we can actually click on the GitHub repository to see more information about this project. And without going into too many details, we can see some of the building blocks of this application. And there are a few things that stick out to me. First, this is using Llama Index, which is a framework that is extremely competitive with LangChain. And Llama Index is incredibly powerful for performing RAG operations. It's also using something called TensorRT LLM, and this is a library that's able to take an LLM model and then optimize that model for RTX graphics cards, greatly improving the response times. And for the vector database, it's using the FAISS vector store by Facebook, which is an open source vector store solution. So basically, this program is a fantastic example of a RAG application. When we select our folder with the files, Llama Index is loading the contents of those files into a vector database. And when we ask our questions, Llama Index is reaching out to that FAISS vector store to retrieve the most relevant documents and then responding with the answers from those documents. But one of the most powerful features of this application is its ability to take these models and then optimize them for RTX graphics cards. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please hit the like button, subscribe, and check out this next video where we build a RAG chatbot with no code using Flowwise.